Welcome back to my channel, my friends. Welcome back. For those of you who are new, my name is Jonathan, and I help individuals navigate their way through their spiritual awakening. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to handle it when things don't seem to be going your way. Let's get started. The spiritual awakening process, the journey that you're on, is filled with many ups and many downs. And I'll be honest with you, when times get difficult, I no longer handle them the way that I used to. Okay, I'll be honest with you, the first 3-4 times during my awakening, when I was working towards something, I was putting a lot of energy, a lot of effort and time into certain situations, and it just didn't seem to work out to be coming forth. What I would end up doing is I'd start pulling myself back. You know what I mean? I would cut back on my spiritual practices. I would start to dip back, you know, from thriving back a little bit into feeling like a victim, getting myself a little bit into a fear state of being, you know, causing stress, causing anxiety, really letting the exterior, as far as the physical things, affect me on the inside. And what ended up happening is this would literally disconnect me from higher source. And my higher source is my angels and my guides. And for those of you who communicate with them, you know that it's not just about receiving messages here and there. They're constantly loving me, encouraging me, guiding me, and nurturing me. And I'm receiving these incredible ideas through them. But it's the better I feel about myself, the closer connected I am to them. But like I say, during my awakening, certain stages of my awakening were extremely difficult. And then by tipping back into victim mentality or feeling stress or fear or any of those bottom feeding emotions, it literally would disconnect me from them. Therefore, I wasn't able to keep receiving the guidance in order to get through these difficult situations. And let's be honest, how many people right now are you able to fully open up to about what you're living, and are they even gonna understand? So even though back then, when things were going good, even though I was alone, I never felt lonely because I had my angels and my guides. And as I went through one situation after another, things started to change. As in, I no longer handled these, we can call them stressful situations or difficult times or these big, massive changes the same way that I used to. You see, because you have to understand something about the law of attraction. You will not receive something when you want to receive something. You will receive something when the universe is ready to give it to you. And that's why sometimes we go through these difficult situations where it just seems like nothing is working out. But guess what? If instead of retreating from your spiritual practices, you begin to amplify your spiritual practices, I am telling you this, a miracle will come. And it's getting rid of that limited belief of a miracle can only occur once in a lifetime. I can't even count the amounts of miracles that my angels have brought forth in order for me to be able to continue on my spiritual journey. And I know it can be extremely difficult to not allow your exterior, what you're living through right now, to affect you on the inside. It's extremely difficult to basically remove yourself out of this 3D reality and raise your vibrations up to 5D. But it's truly important to remain as present as possible. Let's say right now, if you're currently, let's say you're going through a tough transition, let's say during your spiritual awakening. Let's say that you somehow lost your job or you're having to move. Okay, think about the last several couple of months. How has, let's say, going to work affected you? How have you been feeling when you've been going to work or even when you're coming home? Do you feel as if your energy is being drained? Have you been saying each and every single time as you're going into work, I hate this job, I can't wait to find a new job, but you just haven't figured it out yet? Because that's the thing. If that's the case, this is the universe that's just helping speed things up. It might seem short term. Okay, it might seem as if things are really not working out, but I'm telling you this, if you keep on pushing through and you amplify your spiritual practices, as in, let's say if you like meditating, you meditate once a day for 15 minutes. Well, maybe now try meditating twice a day for 15 minutes. You know what I mean? Get yourself more in the present moment. If there's things about the future that are stressing you out, really focus in on right now, this current very moment. And if if at all you want to be able to release this, you can start a journal. Start daily journaling and write out everything that you're feeling, all these different emotions that are being brought up. Write those down, get those down on paper. That's going to help release them. And it's not to say that you won't have bad days. I still have bad days. There's no one who's spiritually awakened that every single day things always work out perfectly. They always feel good and everything is perfect. You know what I mean? You do go through ups and downs. But I can tell you this, that my ups last a lot longer than my downs do now. But let's say if you're having a bad day, okay, and you're, I don't know, let's say you have a chocolate cake. And you're like, you know what? Eating 2 pieces of chocolate cake would really make me feel good, but I know for my health I shouldn't. Well, guess what? Have the 2 pieces of chocolate cake. You know what I mean? Sometimes it's good to indulge in something as long as you're being reasonable. If it's gonna help make you feel better, why not? And that's the thing. These difficult times that are occurring here and there, you know, that are coming through during your spiritual awakening, are all about personal growth. They're all about being able to let go of limited beliefs. They're all about to it's for testing your level of faith. It's to test your level of certainty. It's to test, are you gonna push through? There's a door of resistance here. Are you gonna continue and push through with full confidence, with complete faith that it's gonna work out? Or are you gonna retreat? These are all tests that are being brought forth in order to reveal even more and more who you are at the core. Who is the actual person? Who is the authentic person that should shine during these difficult situations? And it's by continuing to allow your level of faith and certainty to grow and to amplify your spiritual practices that I'm telling you this, it is going to come through. And one thing you have to understand is manifestations rarely come in the form that you expect it. Most of the time, it'll be completely different. I've had times during my awakening where I've managed to manifest things, but because it didn't come the way that I anticipated, it literally took me sometimes weeks to figure out that I had manifested something. So continue with your spiritual practices, continue with raising your level of faith and really being present and really putting yourself first. And you see, you're going to get through these times. And I'm telling you this, you're going to go through this difficult period, and then it's going to bring forth something even greater than you had ever imagined. Because these are all tests that are being brought forth in order to continue to align you with your life path, continue to align you with what it is that you're meant to do here on earth to serve your life purpose. And I really want you to remember something, okay? You didn't just have a spiritual awakening by accident. God chose you to have a spiritual awakening. Therefore, God has a plan for you. I'm telling you this, better days are ahead, and you're going to look back in several years. You're going to look back and you're going to be so thankful for having gone through these difficult situations because of all the personal growth you had, all the knowledge that you're able to gain, how you're able to align yourself up with what it is you're truly passionate about. So I really don't want you to give up. Amplify your spiritual practices, okay? Continue to have faith. Continue to live as present as possible in order to maintain that high vibration, because it's that high vibration that's going to dictate the level of manifestation that's going to come forth to you. And I'm telling you this, keep on shining, keep on raising those vibrations, and you will see that things will get better and your manifestations will be even greater than you could ever imagine. That's going to do it for the video. You guys have an amazing day, and I love you guys. Namaste.